Hello students, in the continuation of the lectures of pharynx, today we will discuss about the structures passing between the gap of constrictors of the pharynx. Now you should know that when you are talking about the pharynx, it is made up of the muscles, which is making a tube of the muscles, and when we will talk about the constrictors, between the constrictors there are gaps present, and these are total four gaps which exist on either side of the pharyngeal wall in relation to the constrictor muscles. Now why the gaps are present? Now as we have already discussed that there are arrangement of telescopic pattern in the muscles. Now when you will see such telescopic arrangement of the constrictors, the gaps are present between the lower part of upper constrictor and upper part of lower constrictors, and these gaps allow the passage of structures to enter inside the pharynx. Now I told you in the class of the constrictor that this upper margin of the superior constrictor does not get attached to the base of the skull, and that gap is known as sinus of Morgagni, and this gap is completed by the pharyngobasilar fascia. So this pharyngobasilar fascia also pierced by the structures, those will pass through this gap, and that's why you have one gap on the superior part of the superior constrictor. So this is the first gap. Then you will have the gap in the lower part, that is known as second gap. Then you will have the gap between the middle and inferior constrictor, that is the third gap, and then it will continue with the esophagus downward, where you will have a tracheoesophageal space, that is the fourth gap around the constrictors. Now when you will see this diagram, here you can see that this is the first gap which I am talking about. This is the area where you have the sinus of Morgagni. This is the posterior part of the middle constrictor, which is overlapping the superior constrictor. This is the posterior part of the thyropharyngeous part of the inferior constrictor. So there are gaps are present, and here you can see that this is stylopharyngeous muscle is entering inside. Now in the last class of my pharyngeal muscle, I told you that all the muscles of pharynx arises from the pharynx inside in the term of longitudinal muscle, except this stylopharyngeous muscle, which is longitudinal, but it take origin from outer side from the stylet process, and it enters inside the pharynx by passing through the gap between the middle constrictor and superior constrictor of the pharynx. So here you can see that this is the one gap, this is the second gap, then you will have third gap. Now here this gap between the middle and inferior constrictor is closed by the membrane. This is known as thyrohyoid membrane, and the structure pierces this thyrohyoid membrane to enter inside the larynx. So what are the name of these structures? This is the most important question for your exam purpose. Whenever you are writing the paper, you have this question. So what are the contents or the structure passing through the sinus of Morgagni? So the first and most important thing which you should know, where you will have the sinus of Morgagni. So sinus of Morgagni is a space between the superior part of the superior constrictor and the base of the skull, and in this you have the four structure: auditory tube, levator veli palati muscle, ascending palatine artery, and palatine branch of ascending pharyngeal artery. Now this auditory tube, we have already seen in the diagram that auditory tube runs very close to the base of skull in the sulcus tubi. Now here you can see that this is the auditory tube. Now this tube is running just along the base of skull, then it enters into the medial side or the medial wall of the nasopharynx, and then you will realize that this tube is having the two muscles attachment, tensor veli palati and levator veli palati. But tensor veli palati, which you can see here, this tensor veli palati is passing below this hamulus, that is the pterygoid hamulus, and become aponeurotic to form the fibrous skeleton of your soft palate. While the levator veli palati is not a vertical muscle, that is the oblique muscle, which is superior to the hamulus. So here you can see that this is the levator veli palati. So this is the important concept which you have to keep in mind, that you are not able to palpate the pterygoid hamulus here from the superior aspect, but you can see the pterygoid hamulus very clearly in this diagram. The reason is that in the lower this diagram, you have the levator veli palati muscle, which is approaching the superior surface of the soft palate, that's why it is passing through the gap along the superior border of superior constrictor. So this green line is showing the superior constrictor margin, and above this margin you are having the uppermost structure is the auditory tube. So this auditory tube, which you can see here, is entering into the nasopharynx, and it is a gap that is below this bony skull and the superior margin of your superior constrictor. Along with this muscle is known as levator veli palati, which is going to insert on the superior surface of soft palate. Then we have the gap between the superior and middle constrictor. Now through this gap, I have already told you that there is a one muscle of the pharynx which is having the origin outside the pharynx. You have the three longitudinal muscle, stylopharyngeus, salpingopharyngeus and palatopharyngeus. Out of these three muscle, the stylopharyngeus arises from outer side and it is inserting inside the pharynx by passing through the gap between the superior and middle constrictor. And the important thing is that this muscle run along with its own nerve supply. We know that the glossopharyngeal nerve is a nerve of the third pharyngeal arch, and this nerve run along with the stylopharyngeus, and the stylopharyngeus supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. So both these structures are entering into the pharynx through the gap between the superior and middle constrictor. Inside the pharynx, when you will see the glossopharyngeal function, it is sensory in nature. So it will supply the stylopharyngeus muscle, then it enters inside the pharynx through this gap and it supplies the sensory part of the pharynx and base of the tongue. Then here in this diagram, you can appreciate the stylopharyngeus. Now this stylopharyngeus, which is externally arising, and then it is entering through this point of the gap, and this gap is between the superior and middle constrictor. Now here you can see that after taking origin from the stylet process, this muscle become here and it is appearing inside the pharynx. So this is the important thing which you have to understand, that stylopharyngeus enters along with the glossopharyngeal nerve. Then you have the lower two spaces between the middle and inferior constrictor and below the inferior constrictor. So this is, suppose this is your middle constrictor and this is your inferior constrictor, or I should say thyropharyngeus part of the inferior constrictor. Now when you are talking about the structure passing through this gap, so this is inferior constrictor. Now there are two terms, superior laryngeal and inferior laryngeal artery. So superior laryngeal is superior to the inferior constrictor, inferior laryngeal is inferior to the inferior constrictor. So if you want to keep them in your memorize these names, so you can keep this thing in mind, that the superior laryngeal is superior to the inferior constrictor and inferior laryngeal is inferior to the inferior constrictor. When you will have the two name of the nerves, now internal laryngeal nerve will go and it will pierce the thyrohyoid membrane. It is going to pierce thyrohyoid membrane, which I told you that it is going to fill the gap between the thyroid cartilage and the hyoid bone. That membrane is pierced by both these structure and they will enter inside the larynx. Then from below you will have the reverse passage of the laryngeal nerve, which is a branch of the vagus, that's why it is known as recurrent laryngeal nerve. So these are the important structure. So in this gap between the middle constrictor and inferior constrictor, you have the superior laryngeal artery and internal laryngeal nerve. Why it is known as internal? Because it is going to pierce the thyroid membrane and enter inside the larynx. While we have the lower portion below the or inferior to the inferior constrictor, you have the inferior laryngeal artery and it is accompanied by recurrent laryngeal nerve. So at the end of this small session of the pharyngeal class, I hope now you should able to identify the structure and you can write down these list of the structures in your exam. So this is all about this class. Thank you.